This is Turquoise for Pax Serial TV. In the studio, we have Tasia Sherel. You're going to be in the upcoming play, My Brother's Keeper.
I am.
What role are you going to be playing?
I play Terry, and I'm actually reprising my role as Terry.
Okay, second time.
Second time.
So that means you did a good job the first time.
Hey, I'll say.
So what's Terry all about?
Terry is it's a mystery about Terry. You know, she keeps to herself. She does her duty, and then... But if she's confronted in a certain way, then she knows how to handle herself. But other than that, she's an enjoyable person to be around, I would say.
There's like a lot more underlining.
There's a lot going on with her. You just come see for yourself.
Yeah, you have to come and see it. You can't give away that part.
Not even.
So you're born in Southside Chicago?
Southside Wild Wild. Now, for those who don't know anything about, that's just in the Wild Hundreds, they call it. It's just something the kids call it nowadays, and I like it.
Okay. So you go back and forth between L.A. and Chicago.
I do. I do as of the past year.
Okay.
I was here uninterrupted for about 8.5 years. So this will be my 10th year, but yeah. So I'm doing some things in Chicago now.
Okay. Well, you're doing a lot of things.
Yes.
So I have actor, casting director, mm-hmm. host, model, motivational speaker, 3-time pageant winner,
that's right,
producer,
girl.
Uh-huh. Stage director,
uh-huh.
anything else?
Yes, acting coach.
Acting coach.
Aha!
Is that it, or is it more than...
Yeah, well, you know, that's all I'm going to tell you.
All right. So let's start with actor.
Yes.
What have you been doing? What roles have you been playing?
Well, I'm known as, for the role I play on Everybody Hates Chris, I play a character named Pam, beauty salon owner. And that show was on for 4 seasons. I was on the show for the 4 seasons.
Nice.
Owned a beauty salon there. So that was nice. We're in syndication now, so tune in every day.
And you're getting paid for that.
Cha-ching. Okay. And then we also have Dexter. Dexter runs on Showtime.
Mm-hmm.
And I play a character named Frances. She's a records clerk. We're going into our 6th season. I've been with them for 5 seasons.
Wow, so you finished now. Everybody Hates Chris and then went on to Dexter?
Well, I was doing them simultaneous.
Oh, excuse
they
me.
Overlap. Yes, darling.
Oh, okay.
It's okay.
She's a legit actor. She doesn't play with the little stuff. Okay.
Right.
All right. Anything else than the play?
Well, we have the play going on. We're on hiatus right now with Dexter. Well, mm-hmm. as far as acting, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Casting director.
Casting director. Do a lot of stage casting. Also, Chicago, and I did a lot in Los Angeles when I first landed here, even independent films.
Okay.
And yeah, I'm sorry, you were about to say
and
something.
And that's it for casting director?
Yes.
Or host. Don't be
host,
taking my job. I'm just
girl,
to,
look at here.
Kimmy.
I'm tired of hosting now.
Okay, no, that's good. I like that answer.
Yeah, you know, just one woman show type things, mm-hmm. you know, and invite the people in and just really just speak about Tasia's talk.
Okay.
That it is, you know, that's what it was. And just basically doing what you're doing, interviewing people about their careers and dreams and desires.
Okay.
And doing what I like to do is to talk.
Model.
Model girl, oh wow. Started modeling about 20 years ago. Mm-hmm. I kind of fell into it. Was working at a company, they were short a model, and I worked in the department. Hey, you want a model? Let's do it. Mm-hmm. And the rest is history. And I fell into the pageant world after that.
That's a whole different,
whole nother baby.
So, 3-time pageant winner. What pageants were there?
Miss Mahogany pageant in Chicago. Mm-hmm. I won a Model of the Year competition sponsored by Maybelline in New York.
Nice.
And placed top 10 in a Miss World pageant in St. Martin. Yeah.
What was your talent? Do you have any talents for those ones?
Acting, modeling.
So you did like
monologues. I'm sorry. Yeah. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Motivational speaker.
Just speak to the kids, inspire the young ladies. You know, that brings me to my pageant, the Miss Embody pageant that I am doing in Chicago, April 30th.
Mm-hmm. And you started that 2009?
I started that, that was Tasia Sherel Studios in 2009.
Okay,
that's
okay,
the acting.
Let's go to the pageants first, because she has a lot going, we have to cover everything.
Yes.
Okay. So the pageant.
The pageant, okay. The Miss Embody pageant. Well, I started Embody Theater Company here in Los Angeles in 2002.
All right.
And from that, I knew I wanted to get into, because I always like, you know, inspiring the young women, you know, and helping to guide them and mm-hmm. with the motivational speaking. I said, well, I know a thing or two about modeling, acting, and pageants. And that's when I started the Miss Embody pageant. I wanted to do it in Chicago, where I'm from.
Right.
Really just get a hold of those young ladies. And the whole thing is we specialize in glorifying the strong young women. Okay. So this will be the first one, April 30th in Chicago.
Nice. What I do like about pageants, because I did a few myself, is that certain things that you don't learn from school that they don't necessarily have in school, you learn how to, like little things. Walking heels is something, you know, not every woman is able to do. Not necessarily
Correct.
That's like a necessity, but
Correct.
It does make life a little bit easier. And it's just confidence.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And, can't stand on that stage and not be confident.
Yeah, and it's not winning. Miss Universe or anything like that. The difference with this pageant is the young ladies, they do not have to wear bikinis. We're so body conscious. I don't want anyone to stop eating and starving themselves. Come as you are. We take all shapes and sizes. And they will have to have a legitimate talent. Mm-hmm. And the twist with the talent is we're not going to have 15 singers. If it's 15 young ladies who sing, guess what? We're doing American Idol style.
Right.
We're going to do a compilation. And then they'll be scored on their individual, on their solo within that. Because it's kind of boring, you know, watching it in the audience. 15 people singing.
It is.
You know what I mean? So same thing with the dancing.
Okay.
Yeah.
So then let's get to your studios. That's also in Chicago.
In Chicago. Okay. In Chicago. At least I rent out a dance studio and I teach acting classes there when I'm in town because I'm back and forth.
Right.
As we discussed earlier. But I'm teaching them the basics. I'm dealing with kids ages 10 and up.
Okay.
And it's, you know, it's fulfilling.
What's your oldest? Is it like to 18?
My oldest that I've had in a class is 35. Okay. Yeah. But they weren't in, you know, they were separated. We have a couple different levels of it.
Okay.
Currently, the oldest is 18.
And does that run like a certain period of time during the year, like 3 months on?
In town, basically.
All right.
Yeah.
So they, then we have producer.
Yes. Produce the independent films that I also cast. Produce pageants and produce stage plays,
And stage director.
Same difference. Exactly.
All right, so we talked about your role. How do you like working with Don B. Welch?
Don B. Welch, OMG. Let me tell you a story about Don B. Welch.
Uh-oh.
Well, not necessarily how I got to get into the fold of the Don B. Welch production house. Stood in a long line.
Uh-oh.
Mm-hmm. What was it, about 2 weekends?
Oh, my.
You know, and I was on Everybody Hates Chris at the time, and I said, you know what? I think I took 2 steps back. But I ran into a lot of my peers. It was a party standing in that line over the weekends. And I said, there's something about this, brother. All these people are here for a reason, mm-hmm. so maybe I should just humble thyself. Exactly, and I did, and here I am.
Okay.
So and I'll be in the Women of Stonebridge Manitou whenever he finished writing.
Okay, well, we're gonna look for you in that one too. Okay. What is it like working with the cast?
Cast is fantastic. This is half of the cast, little more than half of the cast has returned,
mm-hmm.
and we have some new cast members, which I'm always excited to meet new actors. I love working with my peers. I love watching them on television. I love supporting them on stage, and it's a wonderful journey. It's a great way to start off 2011 for me.
All right. So you just came from the holidays into the play. All right. When's Dexter? When are you gonna start shooting for Dexter?
End of May, beginning of June. Going into the sixth season.
And then why should people come out to see the play?
If they want to go on a ride, an enjoyable ride, use their brains a little bit, put the thinking cap on. It's a mystery,
mm-hmm.
you know, if you like it, putting puzzles together, you know, you like playing the board games and you would really enjoy this because it's a thinking show,
okay.
in my opinion.
So for the play, when is it going to be? Or where is it going to be?
We're going to be at Stage 52. Mm-hmm. That's at 5299 West Washington Boulevard,
mm-hmm.
January 28th, 29th, and 30th.
And where can they get tickets?
They can get tickets at Englewood Tickets. So they can hit me up on Facebook, go to Tasia Sherel, and I will point you in the right direction.
And then where can people find you for the pageants, the acting?
Oh, good. Thanks for asking. The pageant, the website is Miss Embody Pageant, MISSEMBODI, pageant.com, or Tasia Sherel at Tasia Sherel.com, or even Tasia Sherel at Facebook.
Okay. Excuse me. What else
do you have? Google me.
What else do you have coming up? Any other projects coming up in the rest of the year?
I have a film, Days of Wrath, coming out. I did with Wilma Valderrama. Lawrence Fishburne is in it. Tay Diggs is in it. David Banner, rapper producer, is in it. Brandon T. Jackson is in it. It's fantastic. It's about the blacks and the browns here in Los Angeles, how they're, taking each other out,
okay.
which is not a good thing, but, you know, it's a story needs to be told, and there's a reason behind it all.
So out of all that stuff, so you have the theater, you have the television, you have the movies, is there anything that's your favorite to do, or everything is...
Acting. That's a passion.
The whole
thing. And producing is a close second.
Okay. How long you've been acting for?
About 15 years now.
All right.
About 15 years.
So you got a lot of things. Do you get tired at all? Or
I do. But I sleep 10 hours, girl.
You sleep 10 hours on top of that?
I don't care. Okay. I get my beauty sleep now.
All right. So this is Tupazi for Pax Stereo TV. This is Tasia Sherel. We will see you later.
Do your own math and learn from the stuff that you are missing. Create your own path with your own vision.